For some reason, there is always a different zombie apocalypse, although technically it cannot really be called a zombie apocalypse. But how would you describe a world when people just suddenly starts to burn, yet be completely conscious, where they turn into walking corpses of fire or walking fire people? A firefighter's job has never been more important. And yet there are some people who can actually manifest the power of fire themselves. Ladies and gentlemen, although I don't think any ladies are watching this, this is me, the angry anime fan, and welcome to Fire Force Episode 1 review. Yes, and yes, I have reviewed the chapters, but in case you're wondering, that has been on a hiatus for a very long time due to the fact that the translation always caught me at a bad time. Therefore, I haven't really reviewed it in a while, and probably I'm not sure when I will come back, but that doesn't mean I dislike it. It's more of the fact that I just don't know if I had the time. The same with these reviews. It's not clear if I will be able to review the anime, but for now, let's jump into the fire and see what is happening. We are introduced to Shinra Kusakabe, a young recruit for a new company 8, where it's revealed in Neo Tokyo, where the world somehow has suddenly burst into flames. Neo Tokyo is the only, or one of the only left places in the world where people can fight against the flames, although what they're fighting against is not considered to be completely saint, as these humans turn into these ravaging, flaming people. Special fire forces are forced to put them to rest through certain methods, using fighting, fire force extinguishing, fire powers, as well as a nun praying to them. And Shinra is called a third generation because there are different generations, first, second, and third. And Shinra is considered a third. The first are those are the victims, the combustion people, as they are called. The second are those that can only manipulate the flames, not create it. Shinra can create it from his feet, therefore he is a third. He is introduced to the 8th Brigade, where he is going to join them, where he meets the eccentric squad. And let me tell you, they are eccentric to say the least. Captain Obi Okata, a very muscular man who trains every day, and Hinowa, a very serious glasses man that practically intimidates everyone, including his own captain, as well as Maki, a very muscular looking yet very sexy girl, and Iris, the sister of the crew, and yes, I mean the nun sister that prays for these souls. We even have a shower scene where we see them shower. That was a very welcoming sight. As Shinra reveals that he has been training at a different thing, he has long since wanted to become a firefighter because he wants to be a hero. The reason for that, because he had made a promise with his mother a very long time ago, the same mother and brother that he lost in a flaming accident. Because it turns out that one day his place burst into flames and he saw a very strange looking fireplace. But no one really wanted to adopt him, not even relatives or his family, because the sight of the flames and the disaster that happened for May traumatized Shinra so that he has a nervous tic. That nervous tic is that he's always smiling. Regardless if he's happy, nervous, sad, or anything else, he will always bring forth a special grin. It's a nervous tic that has brought him a lot of grief. And even in his youth, he was in an unknown place, where he was forced to try to learn his flaming power that summoned forth from his feet. Therefore, people always blamed him for the killing of his family. During his first day in the place, he at first is very scared of fighting, but after some, well, encouragement, he remembers the promise made to his mother to always save lives and managed to finish the job effectively, and also shows for the first time a more genuine smile. He's on his road to become a hero, but the 8th Brigade has maybe a bigger purpose than we can admit, because Obita Taicho tells them all about the combustion method. How it happens, no one knows. For some reason, people burst into flames without even explanation. They just do. And the same around the world. Some people are immune, especially those that can summon forth the flame and those that control it, but others do not. They can turn into flame and they don't even know when. And therefore the fire forces are forced to kill them, because they consider this not salvation. They consider this killing. Yet they have no choice, because if they don't, then these flaming human will rampage and destroy other innocent lives. It is a very tragic scene. What you can say about Fire Force? Well, it has a certain horror look theme to it, but it's not a horror one. It has a light-hearted method in it all, and even some drama. It's definitely not a complete comedy. It's more of a drama combined with some nightmare fuel. But it is funny as well. So I guess it's a combination of every single theme of them all. But I'm joining in this Fire Brigade. We'll see what Shinra and crew will get forward. Will Fire Force be good? Well, the art was kind of clean, a little bright than for it all. But you give me your thoughts if you have any. Oh yeah, and by the way, I have to give praise to Shinra's voice actor. That I thought that voice actor wouldn't get a single job after his first anime role in Asta, because that role felt he had a very obnoxious voice here. But here, it surprisingly shows pretty good. So I guess his career is saved. Now you can give me your thoughts.